Right, everyone, this is FowlZerr, and this is my Lech Poznan squad builder. Another team very close to me, as my team name is Ruben Poznan, a mixture of Ruben Kazan and Lech Poznan. Hopefully you've seen the Ruben Kazan squad builder that I put on before. But, I kind of vowed to myself that I'd try and make these squad builds a bit shorter. So we might as well get on with it. In the Polish league, of course, we have Boric of Bosnia-Herzegovina. 72 reflexes, 63 handling, 61 diving, 61 kicking, and 61 positioning. This goalkeeper is crap. Do not buy him. He lets in so many shitty goals. Anyway, on to the centre-back. In the middle, we have Kaminski. 69 pace, the slowest of the three centre-backs, and when you got a centre-back with that much pace as the slowest, you really got a good team on your hands. Also got 70 defending and 70 heading. Really top-class centre-back. I guess all three centre-backs in this squad kind of stayed on the same line. No one ventured too far forward or backwards, so it was a really, really good, even squad. At right centre-back, we have Arbelida of Colombia. 72 pace, 67 defending, and 72 heading. He's not even the fastest centre back in this team. This guy was absolutely amazing, linking up with the right wing back and the centre mids. Another fantastic centre back. Everyone in this team, except the goalkeeper, was pretty good. Now we have I do not know. But God, that sounded really posh. I do not know. Anyway, 76 pace, 68 defending, and 64 heading. 76 pace on a non-shiny centre-back. Even if he's gold, that is good. And this man was an absolute beast, just collecting all the balls at the back. As you can see, all the centre-backs, 68 overall. Just really good partnerships. At right wing back, they have the absolute pace team, and I think he's from Gambia. And it is Cisse. Let's just check if he is from Gambia. Yes, he is. Oh, I love my flags. So this guy is, as I said, absolute pace demon, 90 pace, and none of the rest of his stats really stand out, but 55 defending, 62 heading, 57 passing, and 55 dribbling. Even though his stats aren't really that good, he's a beast down the wing. When you're against silver teams in the Silver Cup, there's not many fullbacks that can cope with him. Just an absolute beast. And another Grok at left wing back, we had Enriquez of Panama, I think. 77 pace, 64 passing, 64 dribbling, 66 defending, and 64 heading. Really amazing all-around player. His pace is pretty underrated. He obviously was not as fast as Cisse, but really, really good player. Can cope under pressure. Absolutely amazing. At left centre mid, we have our first non-shiny bronze player, and it's Tralka. He's got 65 pace, 61 shooting, 66 passing, 58 dribbling, 61 defending, and 70 heading. You wouldn't really expect him to have that much, well, that good heading for a centre mid. And he's not even a CDM, but really, really good player. Did he score? I'm not sure. No, he did not score. The other centre mid did score, and he was fantastic. Another great partnership in this team. And alongside him was Morawski, who's got decent pace, again, for a non-shiny player, especially a centre mid. 79 pace, 72 passing, 75 dribbling, 67 defending, 66 heading, and 64 shooting. All of his stats are amazing, and this man is absolutely, he's just a beast. He didn't even score, actually. I think it might have been my centre forward that got a few screamers. And at centre forward, we did have Tonev of Bulgaria. Second fastest player on the team, I think. 81 pace, 65 shooting, 63 passing, 72 dribbling, which you could totally feel. I love players with boss dribbling because that's how I score most of my goals. And this guy was just amazing. And he always fed through my two strikers. The first of which was Ubiparip, who was probably my second best striker, to be honest. Decent pace again, 79 pace, 62 shooting, 60 passing, 60 dribbling, and 72 heading. He's got surprisingly good passing for a striker from Serbia, as you can probably see. He scored 3 of my goals, but the other striker, he just felt a lot better. And card wise, he actually looks the worst player, but he's absolutely amazing. This was Slusarski, I think that's how you pronounce it. 77 pace. He's got 58 shooting, 57 dribbling. There's really not much to mention. 67 heading. He looks absolutely crap, but he was so good for me. 7 goals in 4 games in the Bronze Cup. Top scorer. He was just amazing, and I've got to say, he was my star player for this episode. So, thanks for watching this, everyone. I really, really hope you enjoy the next bit of content. Some amazing goals in there. So, see you back in a minute for the star player.
Can I take it that you don't need my help, and I am finally absolved of value? I can face it, but I don't need anyone else. Nobody does it like you do. And for all the others, there'll be better days ahead. And while I recover, I'll be wishing I was dead.
So everyone, you might have guessed, but yes, our star player is Bartosz Slusarski. If you look at him, to be honest, his stats are not that fantastic except for his physical stats. 75 acceleration, 79 sprint speed and 78 strength. The rest is pretty bog standard, to be honest. His finishing's 54, ball control 63, heading 63, long shots 58, penalty 64, shot power 62 and volley 61. Really nothing special there except for his physical stats and maybe his aggression and attack positioning. Just a few on skill. He's got 3-star skills, which I really didn't think he would, but he's got quite a high price for such a low-rated bronze player. But he really defied the odds and played absolutely fantastically for me, so I totally recommend you to buy him if you get the chance. But you probably won't, because he doesn't really fit into that many good teams. But thanks for watching, everyone. This has been FowlZerr. I really hope you enjoyed this episode, and I will see you some other time.